I am so excited to have Dee Dee Blizzard on our podcast today. Dee Dee, thank you for hanging out with me today.
My pleasure. So excited to be here.
Queen of Global. So I'm super excited to have this conversation. We have not had one focused on international real estate yet. And it's definitely become more of a focus in our market, and I think lots of markets across the country. So tell me a little bit about how you got involved in global business and global transactions to begin with.
You know, I kind of carved out a niche for myself. I wanted to find a way to kind of bring the two things that I love more than anything together, and that is travel and real estate. And I've come up with so many different ways of doing that over the years. And I think I finally found the way that works great for me.
Yeah. So how did you really get started? I mean, what led you to hop in?
I started with locations that I love to travel to, mm-hmm. and I started doing a little bit of investigation as to what the real estate market was like. You know, every travel trip turned into a real estate exploration trip for me. And I started to connect with people and build relationships with people. And then I started to kind of do my pitch, which is, you know, if you happen to be working on this, I have a specific expertise that I think will really make this process easier for you. Can we connect and maybe work on a project together? And it started just like that.
I love that. So have you always loved to travel? Was that just a part of who you are? And then now you are able to kind of connect the two?
It absolutely is. Yeah. And I think that's why it feels in some ways effortless, is because it's just really working with my authentic self. What I really enjoy doing.
Mm-hmm. I love that. Now, your business in real estate prior to focusing on this more global level, was it based in residential or commercial?
It was residential, and and for the most part, it still is. I do some commercial as it ties into other projects that I'm doing, but mostly I am based in residential.
Okay. Yeah. Cause I feel like when I think of some of those when I think of like the really mega global folks, they tend to have more commercial background sometimes, but the residential is where that love is and all those relationships. So I feel like managing that in global would be really powerful.
Yes. Yes, it is.
That's awesome. Talk to me a little bit about what you're hearing on a global level. I mean, never have we thought more globally than through a global pandemic. So there's a natural kind of segue to thinking about how has this experience connected us? How is it very different? You know, what are you hearing and feeling on that front?
You know, a lot of what I'm hearing on an international level has to do with the same things that we were focused on pre-pandemic. Yes. So affordable housing on a global front is still a major issue and is a large concern. In addition to that, the goals for lessening your carbon footprint, mm-hmm. the zero carbon.
The sustainability measures, sure.
Absolutely, absolutely. The World Green Building Council goal, which is in line with the Paris Agreement on climate change, that all new buildings be net zero carbon by the year of 2030, mm-hmm. and that all buildings previous to that be renovated to be carbonless in 2050. And so that's still a huge conversation on the global front. And then we're starting to hear, you know, buzzwords like cryptocurrency, blockchain. I was on a webinar just last week or so with another association in Las Vegas. And I was on there with Teresa Grobecker, and she's the CEO of Consortia. And mm-hmm. we had a wonderful conversation about blockchain. So I thought that was interesting.
Yeah. So kind of speaking to the global economy, right? Mm-hmm, that right now mm-hmm. we're so segmented and sort of disparate in managing our own economies, but the global economy can be connected through new technology.
That's right.
Yeah.
That's
yeah. Right. And I think that the issue of connecting sustainability at this time is kind of an interesting question. Like, you know, sustainable communities or healthy communities, what does that That's mean right. in the context of the pandemic?
I That's right.
There are so many lessons and innovations to be learned and thought of through this time period. You know, we think of what's been hard about it, but there's a lot of growth to come that will benefit all of us eventually.
That's right.
Who do That's you think right. is growing most at this time? What country is getting it right?
Oh gosh. I mean, I think that everyone is putting their best foot forward.
Yeah, I think we're all trying.
I really do. And I was really surprised to see all of the different factors of the real estate community that are coming on board, because this is a very important point for us. I brought this up when we were in our year-end meetings in Belgium in December. And I said, you know, this is all great information, but what is it that we as the real estate community can do? And what came back was, well, you really have to start educating your clients, because think about the impact that that's going to have as legislation starts to change. So if you happen to have a client who's investing, for example, in a mega building, and the tenants that are going to fill that building have, you know, protocols in place where they have to be in a green building and meet these certain things, then you're going to want to make sure that they take that into consideration, or they're going to have empty buildings. Right. Yeah. So yeah. There's the educational piece to it that we're responsible for.
Yeah. It's really not an option any longer. It's an expectation of many of the tenants, to your point, but also the potential buyers and sellers. And, you know, having an understanding of global sustainability is not an option anymore. That makes a lot of sense to me. So talk to me about your leadership in the realm of global real estate. Many of us know you as president of FEOPSI. Right? And so talk to me about the roles you've held, and tell about what FEOPSI is, because some people know, but many will not.
Yeah, so let me start with what FEOPSI is. So perfect. FEOPSI is a, it is a platform. You know, it really is a place for people to do, for everyone in the real estate business. So if your industry touches real estate in any way at all, then FEOPSI is definitely an organization for you. And it really comes down to, it's a worldwide organization, networking organization for all professionals associated with the real estate industry. And it provides opportunities for real estate professionals to gain knowledge, to share information, and to conduct international business. So really, I like to say that it's a platform for doing international business. As for my role in FEOPSI, I am the immediate past president of the Chicago Midwest chapter in the USA, and I am currently the board elected vice president of FEOPSI USA.
Oh, I was one shy, 1 year shy of your presidency, but you're coming up, right?
No, actually, it doesn't work that way in FEOPSI, so it doesn't necessarily go. You kind of run if you want to be president-elect.
Yeah.
I certainly didn't choose to do that right now, but I'll be vice president for 2 years. But we just swore in our president-elect, and that's going to be Eugenia Foxworthy, an amazing and dynamic businesswoman. She's based in New York. I think she also does some work out of LA, but I've seen her all over the world. It's going to be an exciting year next year.
Oh, that's awesome. I love that. Do you feel like FEOPSI is a place for the person that's dabbling in global? What if I don't feel confident in that business yet, but I'm interested in understanding it better? Is that a welcoming community for me, or is that maybe a step ahead?
No, it really is. I mean, there's a place for everyone, no matter where you're starting your global career. Because if you're not ready to quite jump out there, well, number one, if you attend any of my classes, I'm going to tell you that you can do it, right?
That's right.
It's just a confidence thing.
That's right.
This is not rocket science. I always tell my students that, you know, to our knowledge, there's no superhumans walking on earth. So if you see one person doing it, you can do it too. It's just about finding that groove that works for you.
Yeah.
But I think there's something for everyone, whether you're just starting or whether you've been doing this forever, because again, you're going to have those relationships. You're going to learn something about how other people are doing it. And that interaction that you get with people who are active in doing this business can only make you hone your skills.
Yeah, I do. I think, you know, all real estate is relationship driven. But when I think about the really successful agents who are working in global and international transactions, they are so relational. It is so focused on who you know and how you know them. And how could it not be? I mean, you're having to work across such distance. You've got to really maintain that trust and mutual respect with the partners that you're working with. So
that's right. That's
it's definitely a relationship driven business more than any other niche, I think.
Absolutely.
That makes sense to me. So obviously with the economy changing at a global level, at a local level, You know, I guess I have a curiosity around how are investors feeling generally overseas? What are you hearing from them about their angst or maybe their excitement about the opportunities that are arising out of this new economy? What are you hearing on that front?
Yeah, you know, every crisis, you know, fortunate, unfortunate, has opportunities. Right. And in when faced, they're kind of faced with the same challenges that we all are. Mm-hmm. But interestingly and surprisingly, we found that the residential projects are still at least being priced at the pre-pandemic pricing. Yeah. And in some areas they're have holding. Increased. Yeah, yeah. They've held, and in some places they're increased. So we're talking just about a quarter of business. But, you know, I rely on people who are much smarter than me, the real estate economists, sure. And things like that, to tell us what to expect beyond that. But certainly, I'm very encouraged by what I've seen. Our projects have gone on, and we had a delay on one of my international projects, but it closed just a week and a half ago.
All right.
And it went very well. So yeah. We had some delays, but things are still moving.
Yeah, I think it is an interesting thing on the residential front too, because despite all of the economic uncertainty, home means more than it has ever meant at a yes. global level and in every country in every way. And I think that that has kind of encouraged along the residential market in the sense that everybody's got to have the one that they need and want right now.
Absolutely.
Yeah. And so pivot is the name of the game in our business right now too. The technology is evolving faster to meet the needs of today. How are you pivoting, and how would you tell the agents across the country to do the same?
You know, I mean, we were all kind of taken aback when this right. happened. I know myself in my business, I had to cancel 13 international flights that were already booked for this year that were to happen wow. between March and December of 2020.
Wow. Yeah.
So, you know, that's a big pivoting. That has
sure.
to happen.
Yeah.
But what we did, and what I encouraged my agents to do, is to let's focus on A, let's maintain our relationships and not lose sight of them. So we're going to connect however we need to connect. You know, right. we are all Zoom kings and queens right now.
And
the truth. yeah, you know, we have yeah. to do what we have to do. And so that was a big focus. We use technology to stay in touch, to stay in front of our clients. It's not always exciting and happy to have to set your alarm clock for 2 a.m. And then get up and get in full makeup, you know, and yeah. dressed from the waist up at least.
yeah, yeah.
But, you know, it's what we had to do, right? Mm-hmm. So I think that was an important part of it. The other side, what we did is we took advantage of having some of this downtime to really institute some automations in our business. Mm-hmm. That has been the name of the game, and we got down and dirty with it. I think I probably set up about 20 subscriptions.
Yeah.
And we started plugging away and doing the work and setting up automations to make our business work better and mm-hmm. easier and more efficient for our clients. And they love it. It's gone yeah. very well.
Yeah. It's so interesting. You know, before we were too busy to do the things that we needed to do to enable us to be busier and mm-hmm. and manage that business better. But, and I get that. I mean, I think we're all that way, but especially when you're traveling all over the world and trying to just keep up.
Yeah.
So that reset, even be it forced, was valued in the sense of if you took that time to invest in your business properly, you should be yielding benefit from that by
absolutely.
now.
Absolutely.
And you'll definitely continue to yield that.
Yes.
That's awesome. Well, is there anything you would leave our members with or agents with? What's the one thing that you would tell them to do if they are interested in global real estate but are feeling a little shy about it?
I would say just do it. Here's the thing. and I mean, that sounds so cliche, right?
Now
that
no, it's all right.
out of my mouth. But really, there's no time like the present. You know, I just, in the class that I just taught, one of the things that I really wanted to get through, and I want to get through to your audience as well, is that this is something that you already have enough knowledge. If you've been in real estate and you've been conducting real estate transactions, you already have enough knowledge to really launch a wonderful, robust and strong, successful consulting business. I can help show you how to do that, but you already have what you need to do to get started. So don't be shy. I am not the only one that's out here doing it and doing it well. There are people doing it at a much bigger scale than me. I prefer smaller jobs because those are my sweet spots. Mixed use buildings, boutique hotels, projects between foreign universities and the US and universities in America. I like to do housing projects and things like that. Yeah. But whatever it is that you like to do, you can do it. You absolutely can. You have the skills already.
That's awesome. I love your encouragement. You are the queen of global real estate in my mind. And I can attest to the fact that you do train agents so beautifully because we've had you here and people love you, which is awesome. So thank you so much for hanging out, Dee Dee. I appreciate
you. Absolutely.